Hello, fun people. I'm Isaac Carlson, and I'm focused on spreading magic by discussing Disney. And today, I want to ask the question, what would have happened if Hans had killed Elsa? What would he do if he had actually taken over the proud, historic, and magical kingdom of Arendelle and became king? And of course, if you are new here and you'd like to join this Disney musical-loving community, then consider subscribing. In an attempt to get my mind turning around the inflection points within the Disney canon that radically changed stories, I turned to the fun people over on my Instagram to ask which scenarios excited them and which ones they would want me to discuss in the future. And this is the first question that I wanted to cover, which was asked by Lauren Smith. At first, I didn't feel the most enthused by the idea because it just seemed like he would be rich, have power, and get the respect that he deserved because he would be crowned king. But when I started to think about how he deceived so many with his manipulative empathy, compassion, and generosity, the premise of him keeping up that type of charade became kind of fascinating to me, especially when I started to think about what it would have taken for him to get away with taking Arendelle. The key moment was Anna dying. All it would have taken was Olaf's carrot to not be able to unlock Anna's door, and she likely would have had her frozen heart consume her by herself. If Olaf couldn't have gotten in, he would have just kept searching the castle for her. Or if he would have gotten in and had stayed with her next to the fire for too long, both of those situations would have resulted in Sven and Kristoff having no way to get to Anna. Even if Kristoff and Anna's kiss could have thawed her heart, they would have never had enough time to find her. With all of these people preoccupied, Hans could have struck down Elsa without any intervention. Sure, there were the Arendellian guards, citizens, and allies looking on, but until Anna arrived, remember, Hans made them believe that Anna had already died. If Anna would have been consumed by her frozen heart, they would have believed that Hans had saved Arendelle and had only taken this course of action as a last resort. Throughout Hans's time going after Anna and confronting Elsa, he had witnesses that would show that he actively fought for Elsa to be saved. The story would have formed that Hans had only taken down the queen to preserve the kingdom. From what they understood, Elsa had killed her sister just after she had married Hans, which meant that they believed he had the duty to take down the dangerous monster that was Elsa. And I promise, I don't think Elsa is a monster. Even though I'm a little critical of her sometimes, I do think she's a generally good person. He's just a very smart villain.
I am the hero who was going to save Arendelle from destruction.
From Frozen 2, we then know that Olaf would have faded away, and Kristoff would have had no way of knowing that Anna had died because of Hans. Maybe he would have even become resentful of Elsa after he believed that the Snow Queen was the reason his true love had died. Hans would likely soon be coronated as king within Arendelle, regardless of whether Elsa's storm continued after her death or not. I think that it likely would have just gone away, though. If Elsa's magic doesn't continue to keep Olaf alive, I don't think her eternal winter would have either. But here, when Hans would ascend to be Arendelle's leader, I think everything gets even more interesting. And that really began for me when I started to think about how Hans would handle working with other kingdoms. Since the Duke of Weselton's disdain of magic and Queen Elsa would have bolstered Hans's reputation and decision-making, he likely would have continued to keep them as Arendelle's largest trading partners, and possibly he might have even worked with them more aggressively. Hans had a huge incentive to keep that man close, to solidify his perception as a leader who made the right decisions within Arendelle. King Hans would have been seen as a hero who rescued the kingdom from a magical villain. It's almost like this is a distorted version of Sleeping Beauty. Everyone in that story trusts that Prince Philip is a good-intentioned man when he kills the Dark Fairy, whereas Maleficent was always perceived as being pure evil, minus the live-action retelling, of course. With the Duke of Weselton at Hans's side, the whole situation would have appeared much more like vanquishing a dark sorceress. The nuance that existed within Elsa and her tragedy would have likely been lost throughout the world and within Arendelle. While Elsa would have been painted as a villain, Hans would have continued to appear like a true savior for their people. I'm sure Hans could have spun the former royal family secretive and closed off nature as a way to attempt to hide their true treacherousness. I mean, he literally could have just told them all the truth of the horrible nature of Elsa and Anna's grandfather, King Rhaenyra, as evidence that their family was corrupted. And the people's last encounter with Elsa would have seemed to confirm that. Of course, you know, no one really knew the true origins of King Rhaenyra, but the point is that they did have dark history in their past. Elsa may have been scared when she attempted to escape her coronation party, but it seemed like she was using magic against her own people and allies, while Hans was nothing but kind to them all. Remember when Hans was in charge of Arendelle? He gave out cloaks, provided shelter, and ensured all could feast on soup and hot glog in the Great Hall. It was a marvelous little feast that he was given everyone. While Elsa's family had shut out the entire world, when Hans was in charge, people were welcomed graciously back in and were showered with tradable goods. Instantly, Arendelle's people respected him and appreciated his kindness.
Arendelle is indebted to you, Your Highness.
Of course, though, he couldn't fabricate Anna as a part of Elsa's treachery, though, because that would take away his legitimacy as Arendelle's ruler. There had to be some faith in Anna and her ability to love Hans and the kingdom, even when Arendelle would grow hateful of Elsa, and that actually would likely even make Hans's actions feel more necessary.
Your princess may be conspiring with a wicked sorceress to destroy us all!
Do not question the princess.
I think the Arendellian citizens could have been convinced that Hans was bringing justice to the beloved fallen Princess Anna. I think Hans would have been a welcomed, reputable, and possibly even appreciated authority in the chaos that had occurred within Arendelle. And that would have only been further solidified when I am sure he would have opened up the gates. Hans would have seemed like he had nothing to hide and was truly good-natured. From there, it's possible Hans may have gotten some type of respect from his own family after his father and the majority of his brothers had been so cruel to him throughout his life. All of a sudden, the neighboring kingdom to the Southern Isles was now ruled by the son and brother they had treated so cruelly. Hans would have been at an equal footing with his father, possibly even stronger if Arendelle was more powerful, wealthier, and more prosperous. And that could have all led to him being appointed heir to the Southern Isles throne, like he had hoped his plan could accomplish in the story of Frozen Heart, which I will leave linked below if you'd like to learn more about Hans's pretty depressing backstory. Maybe there could have been a version of Hans's story where Arendelle and the Southern Isles were united as one kingdom. I've really tried to see if there was a way that both Anna and Elsa passing could result in him being caught or dethroned at some point, but it feels unlikely from everything that we know about him. He was intelligent, a beautiful liar, ruthless, and was able to garner the respect that he needed to remain in the good graces of the world. I believe Hans could have built up a mythology around himself as a noble hero within Arendelle, which would have solidified his royal legacy as king. But let me know down below what you think may have happened if Hans took over Elsa and Anna's kingdom. Also, make sure to subscribe and click the beautiful bell, and then click on another magical video in the description or on the screen. Finally, as always, thanks for watching and have a magical day.